think we, Rob and I, probably met almost 20 years ago.
Yeah, that's a fun story because Bruce and I were at the same conference for several years. It was in the Rocky Mountains, 20 some years ago now.
Before I met Rob, I had the pleasure, of course, talking to audiences everywhere and telling them about this new biology, this great biology, which ultimately says, no, you're not controlled by your genes, you're controlled by your mind, and ultimately you were programmed and your subconscious mind is really controls you and it's been programmed by others. And I say, wow, isn't that, you know, great to understand all this stuff? And the audience thought it was all the way great up until the very end. And then at the get to the very end, I say, yep, and you're controlled by the programs and the subconscious mind.
And people would say, well, great, Dr. Lipton, you know, beliefs run our life and we need to change those. Excuse me, but how do we change those? And he would say, well, I'm out of time now. I got to go. That's not my field.
I don't know, I'm just a biology guy. I know how it works, I don't know how to change it.
This one time, I was sitting in the audience listening to his presentation because I was next up. And he finishes, same thing happened. Dr. Lipton, how do you change those beliefs? You know, well, I've got to go, you know. So he's headed out the door, boy, as fast as he can go.
Gosh, you know, I wish I had a great answer for that. And as I was thinking that, I hear behind me the next speaker and he says, well, I'm going to show you how to make those changes that Bruce was talking about. And I thought, I gotta watch this.
And you could almost hear the skid marks, you know, you could hear the sound of his shoes going.
All these years I'm talking about this, like, this guy's gonna show me how to make those changes. He asked for some people in the audience who, you know, anybody want to make the changes in their life. Of course, almost everybody in the audience raises their hand. And I saw this one woman raise her hand, put it up and then pull it down and put it up and pull it down.
If you know anybody's afraid of public speaking, it's a terrifying sort of thing to them. It's not just a little thing. It's rated next to death, I think. If I have to get up and speak in public, it'll be the worst thing that ever happened to me.
So everybody looked at this woman and she turned beet red. Couldn't say her name. Couldn't even say her name. He had to go out into the audience and sit down in the chair next to her and have a private conversation to find out her name.
So this woman volunteered to come up because I just simply said, look, if there's somebody that has something going on in their lives that limits them in some serious way and they would like to change that, I'm happy to facilitate it here and now.
Meanwhile, I have to tell you the truth, I'm sitting there thinking, this guy is pretty ballsy. The concept that he's gonna call somebody up in front of the room and change their life, and it's like, that, you know, wow. You know, you got to have a lot of confidence to say that, or it's going to be a bad show.
Anyway, she was willing to come up. So I spent about 10 minutes facilitating a psyche process with her.
And he took his arm off her shoulder, and all of a sudden she was giving a lecture. She was walking up and down the stage talking about stories of her childhood and all this kind of stuff. And everybody in the audience, including me, were just like,
she just was on a rant. I mean, she felt so completely different and comfortable. Eventually, she's walking up and down the stage telling these people where she's from and what she's doing and what her plans are and all these things about her life. And I finally had said, look, you know, my time's not up here and I gotta finish up. You can't be talking anymore. Can you go sit down, please?
And I thought about that and I saw that, and it was just, but the whole amazing thing was, here's a person's life that changed in 10 minutes. And it was the most profound thing I ever saw.
And it was really funny because Bruce talked to her, because skeptical scientist that he is and should be, he talked to her and said, so what happened? You know, what was the deal about that? And how do you feel? And she says, well, I don't know what happened, but I feel completely different. I'm comfortable with everybody in the room and I can get up and talk some more. And so he said, well, yeah, maybe that's just a fluke, probably just a trick. So next year, she comes back to the conference. We're both there. And he immediately goes up to her and says, so what happened with the deal about you? Are you still afraid? She says, no, I went home, I live in Florida, and I started a Toastmasters group and I'm winning awards.
And I then started to talk with Rob and see about stuff and said, maybe we should work together. It was a few years, but we finally did it.
So that was the beginning of this really wonderful relationship, friendship, and also a professional link as well.
And it was been the most rewarding of my presentations, because I'm with a group of people that come in with one way of life. I give them a scientific foundation to give justification for this, what looks like magic, but it's not magic when you understand the science. And then Rob goes through the training program, and after the 4 days that we're together, these people walk out, they're different people. And it's like, God, that is some of the most rewarding experiences in life, to see people empower themselves, to go back into the world and recover the control over their lives and create lives that are abundantly happy and fun and beautiful.